Are you? Yeah, there's two of us here. Nice.
There it goes.
Okay, I need to.
Okay.
I have to get my controls up really. Yeah, I got to get my controls up really quick too, in case I need to zoom in or zoom out or whatever.
There we go. I just put you on speaker.
Okay, good. And I've got my coffee. And I have my gloves ready to go.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
You know what? I thought of one other thing.
Yes.
For
Okay, I was actually going to ask you about that because I have this, remember, I don't know if you remembered me showing this. It's an old planner for 2018 that I was going to make into a journal. And I was wondering if I could roll off on these.
Yeah, that would work. I have that exact same one.
Did you really? I love this. And I love how nicely bound the edges are. And I love the cover. And I love how thick, you know, the paper is. And I thought, you know what? I bet you I could use this for journaling. And it was like, I don't know, $7 on clearance at the end of the year at scrapbook.com. So I got this. Good morning, everybody. I've got Norma on the phone with me, and we're talking about my roll-off page. And I'm going to use this planner that I showed you on one of my recent videos. We'll be starting in a little bit. I'm going to wait for people to get here. And then I'm going to glove up. Because you know me and messes, and we're going to update the prayer request, and then we'll get started. So,
hi Holly, hi Kat.
I've got Shauna and Ian. Good morning, Ian. I'm so glad your eye is better, Mister. Had you on the prayer list for a brief time there. Hi, Holly. Good morning, Kat. Hi, Sharon. Tried to catch up and see who I missed that were while I was chatting with. Oh, I got you all so far. Good, good. Don't forget to thumbs up because I'm actually going to put tags in on this one for beginner adventures into gelli plating. Like beginner gelli plate for beginners. Like that. Doesn't that sound great?
Right back.
Okay. All right. I have my trusty, like 16 ounce Turbis cup filled with coffee. And I've already splashed. I'm a very messy drinker. Can you see that? Yeah, exactly. 101. You know, a lot of people who are really well versed with gelli plating kind of forget some of their baby steps. They remember some things that they were challenged with, but not everything they're challenged with. So this will be a good not what to do thing. And look at, I have my little baby hexagon gelli plate. Isn't that the cutest little thing ever? I mean, look at it. It's just a baby. I love that. I love that. And then look at this well-loved gelli plate that Norma gifted me. I'm so excited. She said it's stained but still usable. I got news for her. It'll get loved even more here. And this is a 5x7. So we are going to be having some fun today. I've got all sorts of papers too. Hi, Galena. Hi, Gillian. Jillian. I'm going to goof that name up. I am so sorry. Every time. Oh, and Galena, I'm with everybody else. That baby looks more like you every day. Good morning, Mo. Okie dokie. Norma is guest speaking today with me, as most of you know. We're going to just give people a little bit of time to come in. And as I said, we're going to then quickly update the prayer list and the praise list. And then we're going to get started with messes. And the gloves will come on. Because, you know how I am. Oh, you know what? While I've got you here, Norma, ahead of schedule, let's look at... Can I not just do a Google Hangout? I probably could. Hi, Tommy Joe. Oh, you know what? Norma is excellent, so I'm sure she's going to be giving some fabulous tips today, Tommy Joe. I, you know, never having played before, I'm sure to make all kinds of mistakes, and I don't want to embarrass her, but at the same point in time, the mistakes I make will be well learned by all of us, I think. You know, I probably could, Ian, and that's something for another time. But I don't know how to do that, have never done that. And I have enough stress going on right now that I don't need to stress that further. So, but it's certainly something that you and I could learn how, teach me how to do, right, Ian? You're volunteering for that, right? Uh-huh.
Good one, bud.
Yeah, I'm going to guilt him into it now that he's requested it. Hi, Kimbers. Good morning to you. Contact you later. Okay, you're the best. Can I try like over the weekend or next week? Ian, is that all right? Kim? Oh, we've got two Kims here today. Nice. Oh, thank you, Ian. I appreciate that. I know I have to be careful of the time change, too. Can't you just see me calling you at 6 o'clock my time? That wouldn't go over very well, would it? But in the wee, maybe. Well, I'll tell you what. How do we... I don't know. We'll have to talk about being connected later, because with the time change, that's going to throw a snafu into the works on scheduling, I think. But we'll get it done. So I have these. These are going to work, aren't they, Norma? Oops, what might help if I get them in screen here. These will work, right? Okay. I have some other ones, too, that are smaller, like this. And I also have, like, some butterfly ones that are different. All of these will work, right? Any of the stuff?
Yes, they look good.
Oh, okay. And then I've got my regular 6x6s, you know, different designs. But I wasn't sure about these little ones in the butterfly stencil, so I thought I'd ask. I've got more, too. I've got a huge amount of the smaller 6x6 that are, like, in patterns. And, oh, this is one that I wanted to try for sure. I love this one. Isn't that cool? Hasn't even been out of its little package yet. But then I also have typical doily type things, you know? So, yeah, I love the small stencils too. So, and I've just got a massive amount of stuff. And, while we're waiting to get started, I got to show you guys. I broke down and got some of these bags that, Eileen introduced us all to, and one of the larger ones holds my napkins beautifully because our lovely, lovely lady gifted me a mess of these with a gorgeous card. Can we say who that is? That gifted these all to me? Speak up. You missed going to lurk today, Sharon? Yes, Kat. Our lovely dark Kat gave these to me. I have one that's from a couple, I think, that are from, I can't remember who they're from. One of them is from Zandra. But all the rest of these lovely, lovely napkins are from Dar, a.k.a. Cheshire Cat. I love these. Love them. So those work really, really well for keeping track of these things. The other thing that I did was test out this great big, big, big one. And I'd asked Eileen if it, or somebody ever, I think it was Eileen, if it would hold, good morning, Eileen, if it would hold these big 9x12 pieces of paper, watercolor paper and stuff. And sure enough, and it's got room to spare. If you can see that, there's plenty of room to spare there. So this is great, I think, for my scraps. I probably won't have a great deal of this stuff. I hope not. I still want to concentrate on my fine art painting. So good morning, Lena. Oh, actually, it's probably late afternoon there, isn't it? Or mid-afternoon? So these are awesome. So I tucked all of my, remember when we did the what did you call that? Was with the what is the name of that paint? That's not acrylic. It's not watercolor. It's dries matte. I don't know. You know what it is. And hi, Pecola, Miss Helen. Anyway, it's that G word paint, gouache. That's it. Hello. When we did the gouache on my table mat here, my brain is just toast this morning. On my silicone mat, and we were using that as... as a jelly plate. Oh, Nancy, you know what? That's a good idea. Eileen, honey, could you find the link, or one of my mods find the link for those bags and throw into chat here? And I will make sure as well to put that in the description. Somebody help me remember, though, because, okay, thank you, Eileen, because I will just be a mess about that. I'm horrible about remembering things. Okay, who else popped in that I missed? So I've got Nancy, pardon my bruises. I walk into walls and door frames and things. I think I'm good. I think I caught up on everyone. We've got Norma on speaker, and when we get started, she will be talking more than I'm, unless I have questions to ask. So yeah, I have no depth perception. I have trouble, I tend to smack myself in the nose with cupboards when I'm opening them and stuff too. I went to contact lenses for the longest time because I kept breaking my glasses. Thank you, Eileen. That's the link for the bags that I was just showing you. And trust me, you get a huge amount of bags in there. You get two of every size. And I think there's, what, five? Five or six different sizes in there. So, good morning, Jean. It's good to see you. We are going to go ahead and get started. Hi, Mark. We're going to go ahead and get started. And I want to quickly update our prayer list. I ask that you keep both of my kids in prayers here. As you may know, I live with my daughter and son-in-law. Both Papa and I did until he passed, and now it's just me. But they both have to have surgery in the not-too-distant future. And so that leaves 15-year-old Max, who's last man standing pretty much when it comes to being able to lift anything over 5 pounds with both hands. Cassandra cannot lift anything over 5 pounds. Mike is down to one arm and hand. He can do pretty well with his one. He can like bench press 150, I think. He's crazy. But when it comes to like lifting the crock pot out of, you know, the Instapot thing, he can't do it. So anyway, keep them both in prayer as we venture into that arena. We've got Xandra. Keep her in prayer too, that she continues to heal and get stronger with her knees. And we've got Carrie Ann's little Oliver. Has anyone heard if he's gone home yet? Is he still in hospital? He was in NICU for quite a while, I know. So, hi, Janet. It's good to see you this morning. And we do have Janet's niece, Jessica. CBS last night that I add her son, who's got possible heart issues, which is, she's really frustrated because she doesn't have any information and he's not getting her any information, and he's an adult, so she can't go to the hospital and get information, but she just asked for prayers on him. And has anybody heard how Amber is doing? Hi, Joan. We're going to be using some of your stencils here today. If you know how Amber's doing, I know Ange, we have a praise because Ange has got a job, and we need Julie's father-in-law, Dick, and sister, Patty, and Teresa's daughter, who's looking for a job, and her friend, John, who's dealing with cancer, Dee Dee's stepdad, Ken, and Linda, that's L-Y-N-D-A, friend Cassie, who is dealing with breast cancer and is very young and has small children. So keep her in prayer. And Sharon has asked to be added because she's in a funk right now and has kind of lost her heart for art. But she's here, and I think that's important because staying in connection with those who are around you will feed your muses, whether you're creating art or not. I have a friend, Tanya Hamilton, whose daughter is going to Israel soon on a mission trip. Keep her and daughter in prayer, please. And has anybody heard if Julie's issue with the law enforcement there in Delphi, Indiana, is stable now? I meant to ask her, and I've just gotten kind of off the mark about keeping on top of people with that. And also, keep Carrie in mind, please. Our Carrie love. She's, you know, she deals with issues every day, and the flooding that they've had has been so severe that it has just spiraled her. So keep her in prayer, please. We do have some praises. Ian's eye is all better. Lori survived 3 weeks of nonstop full-time work, which if you know how her body is, you know that that is in itself a miracle. So, and of course I said, we've got Ange's new job, and the last on 426, we had another praise with Gail's dad who was able to skip the cancer treatment. He was doing so well. So there we have it. As always, connect with me through, YouTube's messaging. Just, you know, I think, I don't know if you can direct message or not, but I've got instant messaging through Instagram and through Twitter and through my Facebook page, all of which are linked off of viavon.com. And connect with me and send me your prayer requests. It is my privilege and my service to do that for you. Oh, what's going on with Lisa Scott? I missed that. Good morning, Jan. Do we know, Helen, what do we know what's going on there? Health issues, okay. Got it. Thank you. I appreciate that. Oh, Janet, that's fabulous news. Janet's saying that her niece saw her niece last week and she's doing really well. And that she was able to walk without aids. So they're really pleased. Fabulous, fabulous news. Oh, Dee Dee, hi, good morning. Oh, colon cancer, okay. Thank you for letting us know, and thank you for asking her. There are a lot of prayer needs out there, and never hesitate to lift someone in your heart, lift them in your thoughts, and lift them in your prayers, because it matters and it works. Okay, so we are ready to kick in. And Norma is on the phone with me. Say hello, Norma.
Hello, everyone.
I don't know how we're going to do it, but I trust that Norma is going to help me figure it out. So I've got to get these out. Well, I guess I can take this off, huh? We've already started. Now this, Norma, you had said that you were going to see how well this showed up here. And if I was going to need to put it somewhere else, like on the glass with light underneath it, are you going to be able to assess that once I get the paint on it, or can you assess it now? Bye,
yeah,
Dee Dee.
You can see pretty good. I always use a white background because then, you know, there's no question about what kind of print you have on the jelly plate.
I see. You're talking about being able to see the color and the lineage and all of that, right?
Right.
Okay.
When you do transfers, you want to make sure that, you know, it's showing up really well.
Okay. See, I have this glass sitting here waiting, and I will just throw some white cardstock underneath it. I'll do both of them just so that I do two of them. That should probably cover us well enough, I think. We're going to have some glare from the lighting. If that becomes too bothersome, let me know and I'll see what I can do about it. Okay.
Yeah, I think the white looks better.
The white looks better? Okay.
I say if you use pink paint, you wouldn't be able to see it.
Oh, yeah. Okay, that makes sense. Now, I'm going to just put both of them out here so that if I've got too much color, I can just throw it onto the next one. Will that work or no?
Yeah, that'll work. Okay. Great. Just do two labels.
Well, that's what I was wondering about, is if I could do that. I have to take this off, don't I? Do you leave the plastic off on one side or take it all off?
Yeah, take both sides off.
Okay, that's what I did for
the glass.
Okay. Oh, look at that. Look how yummy that looks already. Okay. So, got my trusty. All right, I'm good. Now what do I do? I've got all kinds of paint over here. I know, don't laugh. You guys are going to actually laugh when I tell you the story. See all these little tubes of paint? I had the orange one explode, and I couldn't rescue it. And so the orange one got thrown away. Sorry for all you orange lovers. Hi, Lori. We just put a praise in for you, darling, for surviving your 3 weeks of nonstop work. So the orange couldn't survive, and it got thrown away. Chuckle, chuckle. And the dioxazine purple also exploded. I could rescue that one. But anyway, in 2016, I had the hives episode. Remember that? Excuse me. And I didn't do any art for the whole year because I was tormented and tortured by hives. And so for Christmas that year, Papa went Christmas shopping for me, and he saw this big stack of color and got it for me, not realizing that it was acrylic and that I wouldn't touch it. So it has been sealed in its sweet little containers, still with the little silver. So we're going to see how well they work today. So I have this whole box of color to pick from. Okay. Here we go. What's now? What next, Norma?
Well, what do you want to start out with? Do you want to start out with color? Do you want to do an image transfer with those black and white?
Oh, yes. Let's do image transfers. Now, also, I've got, tell me which it would work better coming off on. I've got copy paper. I've got a whole mess of stuff here to try today. I've got tissue paper, some that's glossy on one side, some that isn't. I've got, the packing paper that they put in boxes. I've got grocery sacks, white and brown. I've got scrapbook paper and cardboard. And I also wondered if you can jelly onto vellum, or not vellum, Tyvek. Hi, Devin.
No, no. The paper has to be able to soak up the paint. So probably the easiest, start with some copy paper.
Okay.
Need a white copy paper.
Well, and if it has to soak up the paint, then the Tyvek would not work at all.
No.
So I'll set that aside. Okay.
That has a coat.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you, Janet. I like your voice too.
So fun to hear people's voices. Okay, so, and I just pick colors that I want to play with. Is that it?
Yeah, and you can start with any color.
Do I need black for the image transfers that you sent me?
Yeah, start with putting just a little bit of black on the jelly plate and layer it, spread it out real even.
Okay.
Just play black.
Okay. And I know you all are going to be really, really jealous because I've got images that Norma sent me. And I also got prints that Norma sent me of some of her jelly pulls. And I won't show you because I don't want y'all to cry, because you're going to be so jealous. Okay, so these I'm going to just set right here. See, I didn't take anything out yet because I really didn't know what we were going to be working with. And, okay, so just a little bit. Do I put it right on the jelly plate?
Yeah, just put a few little drops of the black paint. It goes a long way.
You want to tell me how to get these little things open? Oh, there we go. Hello. Okay. Like that? Or more?
Yeah, it's a little flip top.
Yeah. Do I have enough paint out or do I need more?
I'm going to push my little live button on that
seat. Hi, Joycey. Okay, I'm going to save this brayer for the baby. Okay. And this brayer was recommended by Kathy. She showed it on one of her jelly plating streams, and I fell in love with how tiny it was because mine's huge and really squeaky, and hers was really sweet and kind of innocent, and I liked it, and I got them.
But that's a good question, right? Where is Kathy Bird?
Is she still on holiday with her family?
No.
Is she back?
I don't think so.
Oh. Well, that, okay, is that good enough? Good coverage?
Yeah, it looks good.
Okay.
It's pretty thin and not dry. It still has to look wet.
Yep. Okay, so it's got to dry a little bit or not dry? Okay, and then I take, let me find a picture that.
Yeah.
Okay, and I put it face down or face up?
No, face down.
Okay, can I do it off to the side?
Yeah, do it off to the side. You can do a couple on there if you want. You can find a couple small ones.
Yeah.
Yes,
I've got two small ones.
Yes, and I'll put another one on the other side there.
Yeah. Like that. Now, do I roll them down or just press them in?
Kind of press them down with your hand and rub on the back.
Okay.
Yeah, press it down real flat and and rub it like in circles, like you're rubbing your tummy or something. Just, yeah, there you go.
Yes, yes, yes.
Here, rub it. Yeah, good.
Yeah, okay. Well, this part's easy enough.
Yeah, and now the trick is you want the paper to pull up some of the paint, and it'll soak it up just a little bit.
Okay. So do I put the paper on now? And this is copy paper, so.
Nope. You need to, okay, pull up those magazines, like, from the corner.
Oh, okay.
Pull up both those pieces of paper. Nope, not that.
Oh, wait.
You need to pull up, yeah. You have to pull up the magazine paper.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, pull that up and it'll leave an image. It should. And pull it up from the corner.
Kind of, sort of, yeah. I think it might have been a little too wet or too dry. Look at that, though. Wow. Okay. And then, my goodness, now I've got to get this one off. Oh, there it is. Okay. Oop. See, this one's fighting me a little bit. Sticking. Sticking. There we go. Woo! Now what?
Yeah.
How do you get that little bits off? Wait, let me go find a little tool. Wait. This might work. It's a little silicone tool for nail painting. Maybe not. Wow, this little piece on the end here is just being challenging. There it is. Well, I'm just going to leave it. It'll be what it is. Okay, so now I put this down and lift it up after
You have to dry with the black paint. You have a hair dryer?
Well, I've got my heat gun. Will that work?
Yeah, the black paint is drying up the other paint.
Okay. Now, you can only use those transfers once, right? Okay.
Yeah. And there should be more black paint actually on the magazine in the gym, so I think the black might have been dry.
Okay.
Okay,
wait a second. Wait till I'm done drying and then everybody can hear you. Because I can't hear you over top of the dryer. Okay. I wonder, is that dry enough, you think? Oh yeah, that's dry. I can get a little bit to come off on my finger, but not much. So what were you saying about these or something?
Yeah, I was saying on the magazine images, you can't really reuse them, but there should be more black paint on them. So I think the black paint might have been too dry because enough didn't come up.
Okay, that probably is because I didn't put enough down there. So that's our first. So now what do I do with this?
Colors. Put a couple colors on there.
Oh, okay. Do I have to clean my ink off of my brayer then? I see.
Yeah,
okay. Actually, it dried on there. So, yeah. Hello.
Oh, doesn't matter.
Alrighty.
Yeah.
Okay. So let me find a pretty.
Pick two colors that would go together.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a pink and a teal. These two colors would. Okay, I gotta get these little. Okay.
Put one dot like on the bottom and one on the top.
So okay.
Two colors.
Alrighty. I hope you're watching chat to answer any questions.
I'm trying. This is not an easy book.
Okay.
Be watching what you're doing, talking to you, and reading chat. Time.
Okay, now Joycey is saying no heat gun, so I shouldn't have used the heat gun.
Well, you can't do it real close. Heat on the jelly plate might melt it.
Gotcha. Okay.
Yeah, it's not good for.
No.
Not good for the jelly.
Gotcha. All right. So I should be using my hair dryer.
Yeah. Hair dryer. I use hair dryers that cool.
Yeah. I've got a hair dryer right here, ready to be plugged in, sort of, kind of, once I untangle its cord from itself.
Thanks, Shauna. Gelli plate is flammable.
Oh.
Well, that's good.
Yes. Okay. Got it. And, yeah, I've got it. Cool. All right. So now I can go ahead and run this over and...
Yeah, spray your colors. Spread the colors out. Just try not to mix them up too much. You
okay.
know, just maybe send top and just run the bottom.
You know what? I've got to...
There you go. Put that pink in your journal.
Yep. And the black is coming off too a little bit. That's awesome.
Uh-oh. Yeah, the black should be dry.
Well, it should be no, it's awesome. It was what was left on my brayer, I mean. Not on the gelli plate. Okay. So see, there was a lot left on that brayer. It just wasn't coming off on the paper that I had it sitting on. Okay, so now I can take this and lay it down.
Yeah, put your white copy paper on top of the wet paint and then rub it with your hand on the back.
Okay. On the back of my hand or on the back of the paper?
Back of the paper.
Yeah, okay.
Put your hand on the
You know, how many times have I watched people do this? A gazillion million? Because everybody plays with mixed media on their sites except me, right? So it's like all of a sudden my brain has just frozen. I think because I'm it's something new and I'm nervous. And I don't want to make you look silly for trying to help me either. So.
Nervous myself.
Oh, you don't sound nervous.
Something new to me. Yeah.
Okay. And then how long do I have to do this?
For a little while. I would suggest pulling up a corner first. That's what I do. And kind of take a peek and see if the image is coming up on the paint. The wet paint should be picking up the dry black paint.
Okay. And you can only use black and white images for this, or close enough to black and white? Is that what I understand?
Von, high contrast images work the best. I
gotcha.
Just sent you a bunch of black and white ones. I have a whole tour.
I believe that. Do you know,
people,
if you ever have a chance to be a gift recipient of one of Norma's boxes, all I can say is be prepared. It's like... It's almost like opening Pandora's box. She knows how to pack a box better than anyone I have ever met. Ooh.
Okay,
yeah.
Now pull it up. So.
Look at. Okay, now it's sticking. Ugh.
Yeah.
I'm getting some paper stuck to the gelli plate.
Yep. Probably left it down too long because you soaked up all the paint. But if you pull it up slowly, it shouldn't rip.
Yep, I've only got one little spot that pulled off.
Aw, thanks, Jean.
Oh, I have more.
Well, I see your question, Nicola. The best type of magazines are, I use a lot of fashion magazines, anything that's slightly glossy and kind of on the thinner side.
Okay, now I have paper left here, which I'm going to try and get off really quick.
Yeah, probably left it on a bit too long.
Okay, probably because I'm busy chatting and not focused on what I'm doing here. So.
No, I don't know how you YouTubers do it. This is kind of challenging to be. Like I said before, reading chat, listening to you, watching what you're doing. I'm not even playing along right now.
Janet, my prayers go with you.
Uh-huh.
Aw. I missed what was going on there with you. I'm so sorry, honey. Tanya, hi. Yes, a box of blessings for sure. It's like when I get one of yours. Okay, so that is...
I get it.
Is any of this still going to be usable, or do I need to clean this off now?
Yes. Do you have baby wipes?
Oh, I even filled the box of them this morning.
Yeah, baby wipes were to this.
Okay.
Clean it off.
Get the last.
Clean it off. Start again.
Good morning, CB. CB, just so you know, I did add your son and his health concerns to the prayer list this morning. And also, Dady popped in and said that we need to keep Lisa Scott in prayers, please. For those of you as well who are coming in late, she has colon cancer, apparently. So.
Hi, Dady.
Yeah, that's a good question. Kenny is asking, can you lightly spray the print with water right before you lay it down?
I don't know. I've never tried that.
Oh, well, there you go. I don't know. Yeah, I think I have spray water around here somewhere. Yeah, I do. I've got a mister full. Okay, well, I guess, do I need to scrub this really hard like this, or... Because it's just like, you didn't tell me I was going to get a workout here. Goodness sakes.
Oh, well.
I won't have to do
it. That tape would be that dry. So.
Yeah, well, see, there you go.
Yeah.
My motto has always been less is more. And so I guess when it comes to the jelly plate, I need to undo that mindset.
Yeah, I always end up putting more black tape on it first. Spray her off until it gets to the point where it looks almost dry, but it still is wet.
See, I'm not sure how to visualize that.
Yeah, that's probably what took the most practice, was learning exactly how much black tape to have on before you put down the magazine image.
Okay.
Try it again.
Okay, and I can't use these same ones, or can I? Can I try or not?
No.
Okay.
No, don't even try. So
I can actually keep these two little ones for in my journal as background, right? Background stuff?
Yeah, keep them for collaging and using on something else.
There you go. I can do that. This pink. Oh, my gosh. It's like Velcroed itself.
Yes, Phoebe, it's me.
Yes, Norma. Of Branson Limousines, Branson, Missouri. Oh, I went to your website. Finally, it took me long enough, didn't it? Oh, my word. Well, see, I always hang out at your Etsy shop, you know. And I had those stretch limos that you have are incredible. They're beautiful, beautiful machines.
Yeah, right now I'm looking for someone to help me with my social media. I need a tech person. I think I have someone lined up.
Oh, fabulous.
Art, yeah.
So you can just make art. Okay. And it's a little bit wet from the baby wipe. Is that okay?
Well, I don't think the black paint will stick if it's got baby wipe wet on it.
Okay. Well, my baby wipes are perfect. I want you to know they're for babies' bottoms. They are unscented and fragrance-free and for delicate sensitivities like a baby's bottom. Okay, there we go. Okay, so that's cleaned off. Now I need more black. And I would probably suggest I use more black this time. A little bit more paint than what I had last time.
Yeah, a little more black paint. Like I said, you can always roll it off and get it at a perfect.
Yeah. Speaking of rolling off. Switch that, get that one ready. Okay. Oh, I have to have my pictures. Let's see. Oh, I have such a gorgeous selection of photos to play with here. yeah, I like this one. That's kind of how I feel some days.
Funny, Phoebe, I was thinking the same thing.
Yes, I know it. That's the worst part about the jelly that I watch you guys with is just the cleaning and the mess. And see, now if I can wear gloves and I've got a little bucket of water next to me that I can put my stencils into when I'm done, that will make me very happy.
Well, you're doing great, Bob.
Thank you. Okay. So now, oops. Yep. Oh, see now.
Yeah, roll off some of the black page on your journal, on your roll off page.
Okay. Hang on a second. I have a slight. There we go. Oh. I know I told you OCD has its moments. Okay. So I have to do what with this now?
After you dry off your sprayer, roll it on the wet tape again. You have to kind of thin out that black tape just a little bit.
Okay. But just do it lightly because last time I didn't have enough on, right?
Right.
Okay. So there's a real delicate line there between too much and not enough.
Yeah. Okay. That looks good. Could you kind of see where, I see where the light was, where it looked real wet and shiny and now it's kind of more dull. That's like the sweet stuff here. Yeah. You got it.
Okay. Now that should be good right there, right?
Right. Now put your image down, you know, face down on the jelly and rub the back a little bit.
Okay. So do you have hubby man on the phone lines today?
Yeah, I don't know if you can hear him in the background. He's in the office talking on the phone. I was going to go close the office door.
Oh, I can't. No, I can't. I can't hear him. I just was asking because I know that you usually do a lot of that. And okay.
I hear that sound. Okay, now just start at one corner. Try pulling up one corner to see. Kind of like you're trying to peek at it. Take a peek and see if the paint has come up on the paper. Corner up.
Yeah. Is it coming? It doesn't look like it's coming up though. Does it?
Yeah, it should come up.
Can you see it? Can you see it coming up there enough or no?
No. Yeah. I would rub it again. Let's rub the back again. The black paint has to come up on the magazine, the image.
Right. So I'm not pressing hard enough probably either. Or, once again, I rolled off too much. That's the hard part.
Don't press too hard that it actually sticks to the...
Oh, okay. So we have one more thing to be careful of. Oh, my word. You people and your jelly plates. Oh, okay.
Just wait, Vaughn. When you get it, it's so much fun.
Oh, I know. Norma, tell everybody how many times you've done this.
Do I have to? I consent. I said when everyone asked me how I've done it or how I learned to do it so well, I just tell them you have to try like 300 times.
that makes me laugh. So okay, so now I'm ready for. Can you imagine doing something like this 300 times? That tells you one woman's determination, or that, or stepping into the madness. I'm not sure which. Oh my word! That
I was slightly obsessed when I was learning how to do this.
Yeah. Obsessed? Oh my word! But that's like manic.
I couldn't stop until I got it.
Yeah.
Is that the definition of obsession?
Yeah, probably. I think a lot of us could take lessons from that. I know. It took me 3 years to figure out watercolor. You know, just. And I'd walk away from it and come back, walk away and come back. And okay.
Well, you gotta dry the black tank.
Well, I think it's pretty well dry already. It's it's dry to touch. So I think that might have also been part of the issue last time.
Yeah,
I've got a fan going on behind me because this room is like a hot box. And I have a fan and my air filter going, so there's a lot of air movement in here. Okay.
That was probably why I didn't get a good image.
Yeah.
Might have been too dry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think next time I will do it a little quicker. I just saw Jean say you have to be very fast. And I'm a slow and methodical type, you know, so. Okay. Now I can put this down, right? Right? Okay.
Yep, white paper.
Okay.
And just rub the back like that, like you're trying to make it stick down.
Right. And then lift it off, right?
Right.
Okay. Oh, this paper is terrible, though. Can you see how that's sticking?
Yeah.
Something is not right there. All right.
Yeah, that one didn't work that great either.
What?
I don't know. I said that one didn't work all that great.
No, and you know, my paper itself, and I'm using Nina cardstock or copy paper, which is usually a pretty good brand, but oh my word, it's just peeling. The paper's peeling right off of itself. So people, these are things of how not to do gelli plating transfers. I'm going to use cardstock next, yeah.
That's what I suggest. Try cardstock next.
Yeah. Oh. At least it's coming off of the gelli plate. I was worried that paper would like Velcro itself to the plate too. So it's a good thing I made an investment in Huggies this week, huh? I don't know, Kenny. I guess I could try on the little one. Norma, let's try a regular gelli transfer instead of an image transfer. Let's see how well a regular gelli transfer does.
Okay, that sounds good.
Yeah, I'm gonna
come back.
Yeah, I'm gonna go one more round with the image transfers on cardstock and see if that makes a difference. And then we will flip to regular gelli plating with stencils and stuff. Let's see if that changes it up. Okay. Let me dry. Okay. A little more black paint, right?
Right. Hi, Julie.
Good morning, Julie.
Yes, she is right. Hand sanitizer and paper towel works good, too.
I'm sorry, what?
Sophia said that hand sanitizer and paper towel work well for cleaning the gelli plate, other than baby wipes.
Oh, I should go get some of that. Right. Yeah, I should go get some of that too then.
Hi, Colleen.
Good morning, Colleen. It's good to see you. All right, that looks great. No.
Okay, that looks good.
Yeah. This is a little bit wetter. That might help. Like this? Is that what you're saying? Like this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Clean off the edges where that black, extra black paint is.
Yeah.
That'll help the image show up a little better.
Okay.
Yep. Keep going it all the way around.
Well, that's a clever idea. Can I just flip it over to see how well it's doing underneath there? I've got air bubbles. Okay. In here.
No, it'll all look black. It'll all look black.
Okay.
Black paint.
Okay.
So flipping it over.
Okay, and
now I'll try pulling it up from the corner.
Okay. Oh, look at that. Oh my goodness. Oh. Now I have to let that dry with the cool setting on the hair dryer.
There it is.
I'm sorry, what?
Yeah. Okay. I didn't see it right away. For some reason, I keep hitting the live button because I'm
hanging
in the live chat.
Huh. Anybody else having trouble with not staying live? Oh, that's
Hi,
a...
You.
CB, thank you. That's a really good recommendation. CB says to put an old piece of paper over the image and it's easier to rub it. Yeah. So if you guys are watching this, I highly recommend you also look at chat while you're watching, because you're going to be also getting great information out of the peanut gallery there. Okay, so I'm kind of sick of pink and turquoise. Let's try a pretty blue and... I have a red. Yeah, these will work. I hope. Oh, this one's gotten opened. Yay! Do I have to open this one? Yep. Much to be said for Master's Touch, still in the box and still workable after all this time. Oh, Kenny, have a wonderful weekend. Thank you for showing up today, being part of us.
Okay.
I appreciate it.
Yep. That looks good. Now, spray her off the extra glue.
Yep. And getting the red going.
Bye.
Not so sure if these colors actually work good together or not.
Well, we'll see.
Well, it's kind of hard to tell when it's still in the tube. I should have done a cheat sheet.
Okay. That's good. I don't want it to be too dry.
And now I can lay it down, right?
Yeah. Lay down your white paper.
Kathy does such a smooth job on pressing down on her little gelli plates, her big gelli plates. I don't think I have her smoothness down yet. Okay, is that should be good enough?
Yeah. And like I said, just try pulling it from the corner first.
Yeah.
And I always get a peek and see if it's coming out. coming up, and if it's not, then push it down.
Yeah.
Oh, that's good. Right.
Did it look okay? It didn't look like it was grabbing enough to me.
Yeah, it's not grabbing enough for black right now.
Yeah, it's not. And that, and it's peel. I forgot to do cardstock. Oh, my heavens. Yeah, well, you know, some people's kids. So see when I said the neon silver blondness would have its way today. And once again, I am getting holes of paper.
Yes.
Okay.
I just need to let that too long.
Yep. Paper was left on too long, and I'm not getting enough of the black up, which I'm not sure how to get the black up once it's dried.
Yeah, the top paint, the color paint has to be just a little bit wetter. It has to be kind of wet to pull up the dry black.
Oh, I see. Okay. Well, heavens. Apparently, I'm not using quite enough, or I'm sprayering off too much.
Yeah, on the color paint, if you just put a little more of the colors on.
Okay.
And, it gets kind of wet before you put the paper down.
Okay.
I mean, wetter. I think that's the problem.
Well, and also I need to be using the cardstock. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, I put the regular paper away and have now grabbing the cardstock. And we're going to try this one more time. With the cardstock. And then if that doesn't work, we're going to straight jelly plating. And thank you for being patient for those of you that are interested in that technique as well. This is a technique that is, as you can tell, challenging. And when you have a terrific person who knows how to do it and helps teach you, that's awesome. So blame the student for not getting it, not the teacher. Practice, 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 practice. Oh. Okay, that looks good. So now I have to, oops, my poor computer just fell half off the table. Okay. That's good. Find another pretty image. This one looks great. Let's do that one. It's got really good. Oh, okay, don't do that. Black. Hello, Jan. Glad you joined us today. Do you have your bean juice with you? Because it's really early over there. I'm going to take a little bit darker blue to go with that red that I chose.
Uh-oh, I missed what Jean and CB said about the paint.
Oh, I missed what they said, too. I don't know.
Okay, CB, you have to tell us, what are you talking about?
Oh, yay, Jan. I'm glad Mr. Bear is getting your bean juice for you. You know, I think I'm going to just try leaving it a little wetter than I had it and see what happens. Oh, can't leave that there. Well, and somebody said to use.
Okay.
Piece of paper that. Oh, you guys were just chatting. Okay. Yeah. No bean juice. No brains. Okay. I can't even use cast up paper for this cleanup or pressing. Oh, this paper is terrible.
All the black paint around the edges didn't come up on the paper.
Yeah. Some of it. And what didn't come up is because the paper was left stuck to the to the little gelli plate here. Wait, it's really being mean to us today.
Okay, now try pulling up the magazine paper.
Okay.
Pull it up. Might be staying on there too long.
That could be.
Bye, Button.
Have a good day, Mo. Can I take it off in pieces? Because it's going to do that on me.
Hi, Kathy. Good to see you.
Hey, Kathy. We were just talking about you.
Oh, left it on too long.
Again. I cannot get that timing here today. Like I said, I've got a lot of air movement going on in here. But, I don't know if we're going to be even be able to see any of her face. I see an eyeball, which is kind of fun.
Yeah, I wouldn't even try it. Unless you get a really clear image on the gelli plate,
yeah,
it would look like a negative. Then you won't be able to, yeah, it's not going to produce anything good.
Really? Not even that eyeball?
No. I wouldn't do it.
Okay. Well, then I'm trusting you.
Yeah, let's clean it up and try something else if you want.
Okie dokie. Well, I am so sorry. This is a case where being able to see moisture content on your gelli plate matters, doesn't it?
Yeah, Pecola just said, have you try another, a different tube of black paint?
Oh, I could certainly do that. I have, is this black? Yeah, this is black right here. Shall I give it one more go? It's up to you guys. Do you want to see one more try with different paint? And
yeah, Joyce said one more try.
Okay. Fine. I can do it because this is pretty much how I'm feeling. This is the picture we're going to use on this one. So, oh, no, get off of there. Oh, okay.
No, it proves that I'm not that great a teacher.
No, I don't think that's it at all, Norma. I think it's that, remember, I told you the neon silver blondness and the fact that I am challenged at the best of times with most stuff. Okay, let's try this.
Joycey just said that she meant that she would have pulled the eye print that you had on there.
Oh, she would have pulled that. Well, you know, there is that. Too late now, though. It was a pretty eye. I will say that. The eye The eyepiece looked really fabulous. Okay. Good. Run this off.
Yeah, Kathy, that's answering your question. Yeah, this is my first time using a jelly plate.
It is. My very first ever time. And Norma's got me doing image transfers already, which is really cool if they would work. Okay, and you want me to clean up around it, don't you?
Yeah, because then the image just shows up a lot better.
Okay. Yay for baby wipes.
See, what did Shauna say? This has nothing to do with either of it. This is a technique that takes time to learn and practice. I agree.
Yeah, I agree. I fully agree.
I think Vaughn is very brave to start. This is her first one, just right out of the gate. She's going for it.
Well, you know, my thoughts are that if I stream and it's an absolute disaster, at least we've learned what not to do or pitfalls to look for that can help us when we're playing with it on our own. And I have no problem being the goofus here that experiments.
Okay, lift up the corner real quick. Maybe we're leaving the image down too long. Yep, I agree with you, Kathy.
Once you get the feel of how the jelly plate feels and the paint, you just get the feel of it. So there you have it. Okay, yeah. Now I have to dry this with the hairdryer, right?
Right.
Oh, cool. Hi, honey. I totally missed that you were here. Yes, exactly, Tanya. Tanya said that if all we see is perfection, we hear the lie that something is wrong with us when things don't work the same for us. Truth. Truth, truth, truth. Well, this is what you all have to understand is that this is, for the most part, a mixed media crowd. Now, they come to see some of the fine art I do, but I told them it was going to be some journaling and some Bible journaling and some fine art and whatever else messes I get into. So they're very used to seeing all kinds of activity coming from everywhere. A lot of watercolor, too, in the group. Thank you, Hydra. If you guys want to learn a lot about art history and watercolor and gouache, Hydra is your girl. Click on her name, go to her channel, and subscribe. She's awesome. I think that's probably good enough. Okay, now I get to put my colors down, right? And I was looking for another blue to go with that red. Yeah, that might do it.
Yeah, right, Connor. Art should be fun. And you can learn.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For sure. And you have to be daring, too, because if you are afraid to do something. Now, there's a difference between not using a product that you have versus not doing art. There's things that I have that I just take them out of their little box or package. I pet them and it goes right back in. and that's just me. I tend to revere art supplies so much. But to be afraid to try to learn a technique, no. Where's the fun in that? Okay. Put that over there.
Vaughn, didn't you say this is your first time using acrylic paint too, right?
Well, not my first time using acrylic. I worked with acrylic for close to 3 years from the first time I picked up a brush, because the person that taught me was a decorative painter working with toll painting. And of course, mm-hmm. she works in acrylics. And then at that time we had the business. And so I got a trial set of the Genesis Heat set to play with. And because I was not happy with acrylics, I hated how fast they dried when I wasn't done blending. And okay, now I put my cardstock down, right?
Right.
Okay. And then, so that's when I got the Genesis Heat set and went into, my very first thing was pansies. And I show that on my blog too. It was horrible, absolutely horrible. But I saw something when I was making that terrible painting, that there was something that I could do with those that I couldn't do with the acrylic. And the next thing I did turned out so fabulous in my eyes because it was a rose. And I had tried everybody's technique on roses and couldn't figure them out. And I learned my own technique. So I'm self-taught with the Genesis, really love it. And see, this is not picking up the black paint either. I don't know what's up with black paint in me, but I really like all those white. Can you guys see all those white bubble textures here? How cool is that? Sorry, I don't think image transfers and I are going, will gouache work on jelly paint. It should, Eileen. But just remember, the difference between gouache and acrylic is that the gouache, which I had thought was permanent, even the acrylic gouache I thought was permanent, is not, and it will lift. Remember, we did a test on that when I did the silicone mat as my jelly plate. So once you put something over top of it, if it's moistured, it will lift. Yes, exactly. It's not waterproof. Where the acrylic is waterproof. I can go over top of this with anything and it'll stay put. Oh, Eileen says the difference is acrylic is so much better. Yeah, well, you know, I almost gave this set of acrylics away. I had them in a box to go to a friend who teaches art in Chicago's special needs community. And I had to go haul them out when I got my jelly plate. That's how close. And she came 2 weeks ago and realized how much was there. And she said she would be back. And she didn't take any of it. So there you have that. Okay. So now I have to clean this off, right? Or can I keep that on there and do another pull?
Yeah. Oh, both Kathy and CB just had a great suggestion. They said put some white paint on what you already have on the jelly plate.
Okay.
White paint first.
And before the black?
Yeah, put some white paint on the jelly plate on top of everything that's already on there.
Like right now?
Yeah. And then roll it out and put a new piece of white paper down and see if you can pull it all up at once.
Okay. A thin coat.
Put some white. Yeah.
Okay.
A little more.
Thin coat. See, now my roller's getting all crunchy and being mean. And Kathy, I got your brayers, although you wouldn't know it right now by looking at this little thing. I have this little baby one for my little tiny jelly plate. You know, I think it's going to actually, I don't think I have enough on it. It's going to dry before I can even get it lifted. It is very warm here today in this room. I'm going to put...
The white paint should be wet.
Yeah.
Because it's the width of it that's going to pull it up on the paper.
Yeah.
It's going to pull the paint up
Yeah, I'm trying to get it moisture enough where I can actually see how moisture content. Wow. My white is, hey, don't look, Eileen. My white is mixing with the red and it's all coming pink. Don't look.
Can't you see? No.
Cover your eyes. No, I'm doing it wrong, aren't I, Kathy? I can tell. I can hear that in Norma's voice with the no.
I know that.
Sorry. Do you want me to do it on the same or on a different sheet? Too much paint. Okay. I'm gonna go right back over. I'm gonna go right back over this. I'm gonna go right back over that. I had I didn't. It was already dry. I could have touched it and it wouldn't have come off. That's how warm it is in here. And I've got a lot of air movement to keep it cool too, because I've got like 5 lights going on here right now.
Well, now the consensus is there was too much white paint on there, but we'll see.
Oh, yeah.
You only need a
Too much white paint. So, okay, wait.
Yeah, just the thin layer would pull up all the other paint. Well, I don't know. I think that one
was better. Safiya is saying to really get in and use my, I don't have that kind of arm strength. Holy cow.
Yeah,
I'm not leaving it down long enough. Okay. But, you know, when I left it down too long, then I had bits of the paper sticking to the jelly plate. So.
Yeah. Well, I'm just going to try pulling it up a little quicker. That might work.
Okay. Oh. I don't know what's coming up, but I do like this print. It reminds me of a purple and pink leopard. So there you have that. Isn't that kind of cool, though? Yes, I'm using cardstock now.
Yeah, you can use it for a background or even, you know, rip it up and collage it.
Right. Now, can I leave on this on here and go again with other paint or no? Do a thin layer of white again. Okay.
Yeah.
A thin layer. Just a thin. Oh.
I agree with Kathy. Kathy Berg is really good at this. She sent me a little journal full of jelly plates that I used as a background.
Have you showed us any of your journals, Norma?
A few pages I put on Twitter. I've tweeted a few pics of some of my journals.
Oh, wait. Did you do the Janet scavenger hunt thing?
I did.
Yep. Yep. I was just thinking, I think I remembered seeing some of your work from the scavenger hunt. If you are new to this channel and this group as a whole, because there's a whole bunch of us that hang out here, we tend to hang on Twitter and use it like instant messaging, so beware. But there is a lot of fun at the start of the year. Janet Young does a scavenger hunt, and it's, you create a journal with things that you find based on the scavenger hunt list, and it is a riot of fun. And on my channel here, you will see my scavenger hunt book review, where I show you everything I put in there. Okay, see, I rub, and it's not coming up. Pushing into the plate. Oh, you know what? I might not even have the arm strength for this. Why do you think I have motorized vehicles that get me around about, you know, my wheelchair, my electric wheelchair, and now I have a scooter for when I'm going all-terraining type things, you know? Yeah, you know, this is just not... And see, that's sticking. You see how that paper is sticking right there? Okay. Clearly, we are being challenged today with the fates and the jelly print. Okay. see if we can get the paper up. Well, I don't know if it's the paint. Because it was doing it with the PBO too, that, or not acrylic, not the PBO, it's the De La Rowney that Norma sent me to use. And she has fabulous results with that. And she's used that on this this gelli plate too. So I'm not sure. You know what would be interesting to try, Norm? If Norma, if sorry, Norm, I'm nothing like nicknaming you. How about if I call you No? Oh, I'm terrible. Sorry. I would like to try a gelli transfer on the little plate and see what happens with that, and see if there's any difference. This poor thing. I do have a larger brayer, and I have to think where I put it. I tucked it away when I got the new ones, which is so like me. Look at this. That black is just really not wanting to come up. Okay, I'm going to
time to switch to the little gelli plate.
Yeah, let's see what we can do with that. I'm going to put this off to the side. I will give it a nice loving bath later. Okay, we have this baby. We're going to try an image transfer one more time using this little baby here. Let's see if we can find a nice picture for it. Ooh. Did you guys see that? How awesome is that print that she's pulled? Or that picture she's offered me. Love that. This little face will work good, I think, on it. Okay. So, hi, Vanessa. The black won't come off because I used the hairdryer, but that's part of the image transfer process, is that the black has to be dried. Yes, rubbing alcohol probably, or some hand sanitizer I've heard works really well too. So, I know, isn't this adorable? Okay, so I'm going to put the black down. I'm going to try your black paint. I need more. Coming up, and I can't tell if it's coming up because of this brayer or this is the brayer you used. I'm sure of it, Kathy, isn't it? This set. Okay. Is it possible that it's because I've got too much black?
Yeah, too much black is a possibility. And the black paint, it has to be not real, like, juicy wet, and it can't be dry. There's a sweet spot right between it being real, real wet and going to dry.
Okay.
That is the perfect right thing.
Well, let's give it a try.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I agree, Colleen. I think there might have been too much black.
Too much black on the original? On this one?
Yes.
Probably too much black on this one, too.
Yeah, with it, yeah.
Yeah, see, I had too much black on that one, too, then. Because it just lifted right off without any of the image transfer. Too wet. That's what that was.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, all you got is just her hair. You can kind of see the hair print on the Gelli Plate.
Yeah.
Look at it again.
Sure, I've got a picture ready to go here. I know. Okay, let's try that. Yep. Okay, there we go.
Yeah, spray it off on your journal.
Yep, did that. You should see my journal page.
Okay.
It's pretty ugly. Yeah. And I had another journal page before that, and my pages are all sticking together. So, okay. Okay, so now this should give it a good rub, right?
Yep. Rub the back so that the magazine paper pulls up the black paint.
Yep.
Some of it.
Like that? Can you see it? The yep. eyes? Yep. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, you got a good image there. So that,
yes.
that should work. So dry it. You need to dry the black paint.
Okay.
Put your hair dryer on there.
Yep.
Hi, Teresa.
I know. Isn't that amazing, Tanya? I would have squealed, but I was afraid it hurt your eardrums. Okay, that should do that. And now I can put, I'm just going to use a little dab of pink. Now, does this have to be a lot or a little? I can't remember already. Short-term memory issues. A lot of pink or a little bit of pink?
Well, a little more than what you have.
Okay.
Yeah, it has to be wet.
Okay.
The pink has to be wet to pull up the black.
All right. Little bit more than that probably then, huh? I like how the having the black dried means it's stationary when you're pulling over the colors atop it. Now can you usually see your image through or no?
No. Just barely. You should be able to your image just barely like it is.
Okay.
Yeah. Everyone's going wow in chat. I think I'm lagging behind here.
Yes. Yep. Oh, not too late. I rolled some of the paint off. Less works better. Okay. I should have cut these papers down so that I can work with them a little bit better. I did it. Look.
Yeah.
Look at that. I did it. Look at that.
Yeah.
It worked on the baby. Oh, that's awesome. That is awesome. I'm going to just frame this just like that. I'm going to go buy a little circle frame and put it in it. I think it deserves to be framed, right? I know, Kat. Oh, this is so funny. Oh, my goodness. Okay, so now let me ask you this. If I had this little baby jelly sitting on one of the little plastic discs that it came with, would that allow me to pick it up and put it down onto a journal or onto a piece of paper or onto another image of some sort, whether it's cardstock or other like napkin or onto something like this or whatever? Would it allow me to do that or no?
Yeah, I don't know. That's a good question,
Bob.
I don't know.
Okay. Anybody else now? No? You can stamp with the small ones, like pick them upside down and use them like that? Let me get... I got to figure out where I put the little plastic discs. Oh, I know. Where's my little keeper for it? And here it is. Well, somewhere I have little plastic discs that it came on, and now of course I've lost them in all this kerfuffle here. Oh well. Let me put it on top of this. That might work. Yeah, that'll work. Okay. Okay, now I have to wipe this off between this and the next run, don't I?
Yeah, or, I see everyone is going, oh my goodness, and the crowd goes wild. I have, excuse me. Yeah, there is a lag.
Yeah. We had success. Whew! Okay, so let's take this one and see if we can do some stamping onto it and also into or some of the texture or the stenciling. The stencil stuff. Oh, I envy you people that have more than one spot that you're sitting at right now to spread out or to put things on your floors. Oh my word. Okay. All right. Keeping, wait. Oh, I just need color now, don't I? Like. Let's see. Okay. Gelling takes up a lot of space pretty darn quickly. Yeah, it does. But it's so fun. Okay, now, how do I do this with a stencil? The same process where I put down paint and then lay my stencil atop it? Is that what I do? No, my baby wipes do not have aloe or cream in them. They are... Huggies. No fragrance, no nothing for sensitive skins. Just nothing is in them at all. Clotheslines, yes, but then not all of us have this lovely outside area to art in, Miss Jan. Okay, Norma, do I just throw paint down and then brayer it and then a stencil over top of it? Norma?
Yeah, I was reading what Jean was saying.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
You can do it either way.
Okay.
Yeah, put some paint down and then put a stencil on top of the paint and then put paper on top of that.
Okay, and I can do more than one color on this little baby, right? Right? I just can't. Oh, here it is.
Tiny plate, but
you can use more than one color. Okay. All right. I like those combos of colors. And then I don't want to do it on that one. Well, let's just I have my stencils all buried too. Oh my word.
Use a little stencil.
Yeah, use a little. Well, I've got little baby designs here. Will that work or no?
Yeah. Put one of the little stencils over the top of the paint.
Okay.
There, that'll be a good one.
Yep. Okay. And then put the paper on top and pull it off, right?
Right.
Okay.
You have to put the paper on top and rub it a little bit to get the paint on the paper.
Right. These stencils I got at iStencils, and they are part of, good heavens, Patty Tolly Parrish's. I don't know. Joan, are these your stencils, honey? Are you still here? Or are these Patties? Or I had fun there when those were on sale. Oh, look at that. Look how cute that is. So now if I pull this, it should give me a relief print, right? And I should be able to get this off.
Right, yeah. Paint on the stencil. There you go.
Press
it down.
Right. Oh, see how fast that's drying? I'm not sure if I'm even going to be able to get a print off of this one because it's so fast drying here. Oh, it did. I got it. Oh, okay. Oh, look at that. Oh, let it dry and add a thin layer of another color and pull. That's a great idea.
Another color would have pulled it out too.
Oh, I didn't think about that. Okay, so let's try it again. I love that. I love these greens together too. Gorgeous.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, where's Kathy Burns? She's really good at this. I've seen her do so many, and she's even sent me some of hers that I just love.
Oh. I have watched Kathy do this over and over again, but watching it is way different than doing it. And
I agree.
There's just a huge amount of difference. The nice thing is that this little one is easier to manage than I think one of those big ones would be.
Yeah, I think you're right. Probably we should have started out with the little one, but you're doing great.
Well, thank you. I'm not done trying image transfers. What I needed to do and should have been doing all along is, I'm going to have to go back and watch this video again, is to remember the steps of the black, then the print, and then pull the print, dry the black, and then go over with another color, and then the paper, and then the pull, right? Is that the order of sequence there?
Right. Look at what Kathy just wrote in chat. She said, you're thinking about it too much.
Well, of course, I'm thinking about it, because the unmitigated disaster that would occur if I weren't thinking about it would not be appreciated by anyone, I'm sure. Okay, so now I can go back over top of this. Is that what I heard? With another or through the stencil? Is that it? Anyone?
I would pull the stencil off and then put paint on top of.
Gotcha. Okay.
Yep.
Doing that.
Okay. You have a different color than the green, right?
It's a dark green. And the under color was... Oh my heavens, my brayer just fell apart.
Oh no.
It did. Oh dear. Well, you've seen it all now, folks. See, now this is why I'm very happy I'm wearing gloves today to reassemble my. So weird. It looked like it's screwed in, but it's not a typical screw. It's like a little round screw in there. It's weird. Okay. Well, hopefully that's good enough. And now I have a baby brayer too. I have this little baby one sitting right there. I wish I could remember what I did. I'm not seeing my big brayer. I have no idea where I put that silly thing. Oh. See, I think it had too much drying time while I was trying to put the brayer together. But I can do something else through this now, right? Or do I have to clean this up? Hi, Judy. You been out tooling in your new car?
Sorry.
No, problem. Do I have to clean this off now again? Or can I leave what's on here for the next pull? Okay. Don't clean up. Okay. Let's try. I know. Let me find a pretty.
Yeah. I mean, I like that. Whatever.
Eileen, do you gelli plate? Okay, so that. All right, let's swap out the design. I have to laugh at you guys because Eileen would probably force Janet to make them for us. There. Can you guys see that okay? Isn't that pretty? I should have used a white now. But you know what? I can always go over and add detailing on that kind of stuff if I want it. Hi and goodbye, Miko. Honey, I am so sorry. I didn't even catch that you were here. Sleep well. I'm sure Brooke is on her odd sleep pattern. Okay, so now I can go over that with another color, right? What would happen if I go over it with white? Is it going to show up or no? How about?
Yeah, you could try.
Could I? Let's see.
Yeah. Give it a try. Bye, Gail.
Have a good weekend. A thin coat, yes. Thin coat. Bye, CB. Thank you for being here. Have a fabulous weekend. I'll catch some of you on Twitter. Work out very good. But you know what I think? I think I didn't have enough of the undercolors left to do that, to have it show up well.
Yeah, usually the wet paint on top will pull up the undercolor, the drier.
And it's, and mine is really struggling with pulling those off, and I'm not sure why. I have to believe that it has to do with the the dryness right here in this room, because this room is like probably close to 80 degrees, even with the fans going. And it's only 50 something outside. So, and okay, so if that's not going to pull up, and I'm going to try one more tactic to get it to pull up.
Yeah, try one more time with some wet paint. Yeah. Kathy, what would you do?
There you go.
Oh, Colleen, stay and pull another print.
Yeah. Okay, pull it with it like this right now, or with another stencil print? Yes, it's not always about the perfect, Tracy. You are so correct there.
Yes, DB, I'm not so sure, but thanks for the encouragement.
Oh, Kathy says just to keep going. Don't clean till I'm done. Wow. If I use a stencil, switch the stencil. Okay, gotcha. Well, I certainly have enough stencils with which to switch. Yeah, those undercoat coatings are staying put. They're simply not moving. So, well, fine. They'll stay there then, right? Is that what I'm hearing being told to me? Let's see. Let's try. Oh, no, I better not do that. Some people don't like pink. I don't know why not.
I like pink.
I like pink, too. Pink, pink, pink. It's my favorite. And I'll do a little of this green. Ooh. Oh, this is Christmas colors. Woohoo! I'm careful. I'm going to make mud.
Bye, Kathy.
Bye, Kathy. Have a good weekend. The paint I put on there would have done 4 prints. I know. I don't understand what's going on here. Well, I do. I think it's probably how dry it is right here. 2 much paint. Well, sorry.
Yeah.
You know, I kind of like, you know what I like is the texture of this, where you're just getting some color, some mix, and some pure. That's I really like that. And then.
Yeah, I like it too. The thing with jelly printing is they all turn out different. You know, it just varies so much on the result.
Right. Well, but Jean, doesn't it depend on the thickness of the paint as well as the moisture content in the paint? As to how good the pull is going to be? Because look, that one turned out really good and it lifted a lot of that bottom. And this is, you're telling me I've got way too much paint, and yet it's finally pulling up what was underneath it. So I'm confused then on what really is best and what isn't best. Because I really like this. I think this one turned out really cool. And this was the final,
like
the final pull from these three. Yeah, but yes, the last, it had, this one pulled up this, what was on there from this. So, because you can see very carefully that it's got a lot of that jade green in it. So, but it was the, and that was dried on there. So, oh. I just think that's interesting how it reacts so differently. All right, I'm going to switch to a different stencil. And where did I go with that? Here it is. I like these. Okay, so I can keep this on here, right? Now, what's going to happen if I do like black over top of that? Will it pull it? Will it pull those colors over? Thank you for coming, Hajra. It's so good to see you. Hugs and kisses to you too, sweetie. We need to voice again soon, okay?
I don't know about black. Try white or just try a lighter color. Might work.
Okay. How about if I try a light yellow? How about that? Oh.
Yeah, try it.
These poor things. That's actually, I shouldn't fuss that it's.
Just one little drop of yellow
because
it's such a tiny plate. So.
Yeah, but remember, it was all that
extra paint I put on it on that last one that did such a great job. So
yeah,
we'll see what happens with this one. Of course, it could be too how much pressure I put on it. I don't know.
It's funny. Colleen said you like using too much product. Like she does.
There. Oh, look at that. Can you guys see that? How delicious is that? Oh, I love that. That is, you know, you can also see where my fingers have pushed down. Oops, fingers pushed down on it, and it lifted some of that. I think part of it's my pressure. I honestly think part of it is my pressure. I am. It's fun. It's not stressful when I've got Norma here and you guys here to help me figure out what I'm doing. Use my brayer for pressure. I mean, use when I put this down, use my brayer over top of that.
Yeah, brayer on the back of your paper.
Okay.
Instead of just rubbing with your hands, use your brayer on the back of the paper to add more pressure.
Oh, that might work. Of course, my brayer, the way it's falling apart, who knows? I think those will have to go back to the store for a replacement. You can see where my hand, my finger, you know, fingerprints were on there, but I like that because it added extra texture to this. Oh, this one I absolutely love. Okay. So, I have a new stencil. What was I supposed to do next? I forgot. Oh, just paint, right? Paint and play? Okay. So, put down one of those. And a little bit of this.
And Joyce is saying that the black paint will work, but just real thin. Use a little bit.
Okay. Gotta get my paint out from underneath it so that the stencil will lay flat. There we go. Oh, how cool. Okay, so now that's there. Get my paper. Oh, that's right, brayer. I don't know, it's kind of hard to feel where the stencil's at with the brayer because I can't feel, I can't feel the edges of the gelli plate through the brayer. This is where it might be better to flip it upside down. Hi, Dot. How's Big Sis doing today? Oh, use my fingers for this part. Okay. Alrighty. Oh, look at that. I love that. Can you guys see the colors on that?
Yep, that's pretty.
Yeah, that turned out really good. Okay. Wipe that off there. Now, let's see. This might look good with a little bit of the black on it to pull and get those colors to pull up. Ah, Debbie, welcome. I'm so glad you managed to locate us. Gelli plating adventures for the first time. I will take photos of the images when I get done today and show you guys.
my dad styling. At least trying to be funny.
Yeah, this is my cardstock, my Nina Bright White cardstock. But I do have a lot of other paper I would like to try. Not sure how well it will be successful, but I would like to try it. Oh, look at the elegance of that. Can you guys see that? There is a multitude of color in this one that the camera is not picking up. It is just gorgeous. It's very elegant. Oh, we already did that, Colleen. You missed it, honey. It was on the first. That was what we did first. And it was challenging me all the way up to when I just got a good one and we called it quits. Look at this. This was my, can you see that?
Yeah, last one was the best.
Yep. I got that one to come off, Colleen. Can you believe it? The crowd cheered. Literally. I squealed. Okay. Well, that's the only one that we got to come out very well. So, oh, I love this. This is so pretty. And the camera isn't even catching 99% of it. Oh, how tragic is that? Okay, so let's.
Sophia said to boldly go where no bond has gone before.
Yes, exactly. Oh, map paper. I don't have any map paper. Kimber's good luck. Is Beef going to help you mow the grass? I do have a whole lot of other papers here. And we could try, this is paper bag. We could try that. Let me see what colors I want to play with next. Yeah, I think I'm going to go with I lost my baby pink, which, here it is. Cover your eyes, Eileen. Pink is so not her favorite color.
Okay. And Debbie said that magazine pages and book paper are great too. She has an old
college textbook
that she likes to use. I also use dictionary, old dictionary paper.
Yeah. I envy you girls that really have a good grasp on doing all of this. Because I'm just tickled when it comes out with colors I like. To heck with what the print looks like. It's got the colors I like. I wish you guys could see this one. I'm going to take photos specifically of a few of these to show specifically because they turn, and this one's going in the mix because I did it. Because some of them, even though this has got colors that I'm not overly fond of, they're typically the oranges and rusts, but these are fall colors when all put together with the greens and the reds, and it just makes me think of Vermont in fall, and I've been to Vermont many, many times in the fall.
Now, I'm so impressed with you, Vaughn. Just learning a new thing. It's fun. You get to experiment, play around.
Thank you. It is fun. I really am enjoying this. I like the patterns that we get and the Now, I can go over this, right? I can go over this with another color. I don't have to just pull from this one first.
Yeah, put on a lighter color, like the lighter blue, and you'll pull up the darker underneath it.
Well, I just did. Never mind. Too late.
All right.
I was too excited.
Bye-bye.
Have a great day, honey. Have a good weekend. Did you guys see what I did there? Ha, ha, ha. I lifted it upside down. I can get better pressure with this, too. Okay. That one, the pattern didn't come off like I thought it would. Because this pattern should have. Now I can come back with this and do another pull though on that, right?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, you can do it.
So if I want to do like a white, could I do that? And then pull it on that dark grunge?
Yeah, you can do a white or yellow, anything that's brighter than the darker underneath it.
Right. Okay, so put that there, lay that down, and line it up. Let the first layer dry before you add the second one, Debbie Riddick says. Well, I don't know if I did that.
Yes, good point, Debbie.
There. So that worked too, though. Look at that left, what's left. So if I let this dry right here and then put like a black over top of it, that will pick up that texture or a dark blue or whatever.
Yeah, it should. Because the dry paint that's on the jelly plate, let that dry and then you put wet on top of it. And paper on top of that, it's the wet paint that pulls up the dry paint.
Gotcha. Okay. So basically, I can just sit here and wave it and it'll be dry in 2 seconds. I don't really even think I need the hair dryer today, Jean. Honestly, things are drying so quickly here that.
Well, Jean, I think she's given up on the hair dryer.
Well, it was just a thought.
Yeah.
Just a thought. I want a dark, pretty on a dark blue. Oops. I should make sure that caps on good. Oh, this is dioxazine purple.
Yeah, Debbie said, just make sure that your second paint layer is thin.
Yes. Okay, so it is still wet. All right. Take the little hair dryer on cool. Is okay. My guest speaker with me today is Norma, Branson Limousines, also NormaJean Handmade Art on Etsy. And if you have not visited her Etsy store, you are in for a treat. When this video is done, I will have links to products and stencils and Norma's site and there was something else I was supposed to link. What was it? Oh, good heavens. My brain just seized on me. I have no clue. Whatever it was, it's gone now. Somebody help me. Who was in charge of writing that down for me?
I wrote it down for you. You're supposed to remember to put the clear bag that you showed in the beginning.
Yes, that's right. Thank you, Norma.
Okay, thank you.
And Norma also provided us links to a lot of your videos for others that are looking to learn more when they get beyond this beginner stage. So
thank you, Jean.
Look at that. Look at that. Can you see? Look at that. I like that one too. I also like the halo that it took because it was taking off like a, look at this. Look at how clean this is. That is amazing to me.
That was a good one.
That was a very good one. And I love all the layers of color that you see through these. Yeah, it does. It really does.
I like the layers.
Oh, I do too. Okay, now I'm going to hang on to that one. Okay, so.
Now the trick is you have to remember what you just did to get those results.
Oh, no. There will never be a duplicate, ever, because I will never remember. It's one of the things that I love about Genesis is that I don't have to, I don't have to try and remember how I got my mixes. I just leave it on that, you know, non-porous surface, and it'll stay and keep there as long as it's dust covered for all that time. It's awesome. Oh, I think this poor, and my gloves are getting so sticky, I can't hardly even pull the paper that just got pulled up on this. All right.
You can always put on fresh gloves if you want.
I may have to. It'll help if I can move and get a new paper too that I'm going to be glaring off onto.
God, AJ just said, funny, Norma, a test, remember how to recreate it.
Yeah, I know it. See, AJ understands. AJ.
Try to do it again, yes.
Okay. Okay. So I have that. Let's see what I want to do next. Oh, yeah, let's kind of get a leopard print going here. Or, well, not a leopard print, whatever. You know what I mean. So I have to do a pull on that, right? Yeah. Yes, this is how the addiction begins. Exactly, Kimbers.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Sorry.
The nice thing is that when you're playing with this, you have, oh, I like that. You have the opportunity to do it at your own pace too. And that makes a big difference.
Yeah, I'm gonna say it again. I'm so amazed at all you YouTubers, how you can, you know, be live streaming, be arting, talking, and watching chat at the same time. Seriously, I'm amazed that you all can do this.
It's one of the reasons why I don't get much done on my, I'm not very good at it yet. And I don't think I'll ever probably be very good at it because I like the chatting and the interaction. So, you know, it takes me 5 months to get any project done. And I always say I'll record it. No, I just make you come and watch me work on it some more, like every 4 weeks. Because that's how
you're better at this than you think. You're doing great.
Thank you. It's fun having somebody else, like when Kathy helped me with the jelly when I was using my silicone mat as a jelly print with the gouache. That was so fun to have somebody else kind of there to help watch chat. And okay, I'm gonna do it this way. I can get, oh, look at that.
Well, this is my first time being a guest speaker, and it's your first time doing Gelli Plate, so
this is great. And you're doing fabulous, Norma.
Yeah, it's harder than people would think.
Yeah. Okay, that got a little bit up, but not a lot. Apparently, I didn't let that under dry enough. So let's do it again.
Thanks, Pacola. Pacola just said that the two of us are doing great.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So, you know, having somebody with you when you're doing this and talking with you is really fun. And it's almost kind of addictive because you get spoiled with somebody else helping you watch what's going on screen.
Yeah, Colleen just said that the second prints are always better. I agree. And it's so much fun. You never know what you're going to get. You're always thinking, okay, the next one's going to be better. The next one's going to be better. And that's what drives you to keep going.
Yeah. It's fun. I love this baby. I could sit and play with these little baby ones all day. They're so less stressful in the long run too, because they're so tiny that you don't have to have, you know, your whole workspace taken up with. And that's why I like this little one that is currently drying out over here.
No, I agree. The little one's working better for you today.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
That's a lot. I think that's about time for me to switch out my gloves here too. Okay. I don't think this particular print likes me very well. But it also could be the paper I'm using. So now when this dries, which it's going to, let me get a sip. I haven't even had a third of my cup of coffee. Now I can go over with the dark. And that should pick up, right? I am so glad you had me do the glass mat. It's going to be so much easier to clean up than the silicone mat would have been. Judy, do you have flooding risk right there, right now? Oh, honey. Okay. I'm lifting a prayer right now for you.
Yes, me too. Praying you stay dry.
Well, the peachy did not come out right, but that's kind of cool. And if I let that dry, I could go over that with like the teal, couldn't I? Teal and brown are a good color combination. Yes, Eileen, pretty much. That's frightening. I hate sirens of any kind. Oh,
Eileen. Fun. Read what Eileen said.
Yes, I did. And she's not far off the mark on that either. It's frightening. It's just frightening. Okay, so now I can put this down. Actually, I don't know if I want that teal. Maybe a yellow. Do I have like a... Yes. Let's throw some yellow ochre on there.
I think yellow would show up better.
Yeah, the yellow ochre. It's a little darker, but it would work very nicely with it. Well, it could be transparent, but I'm putting it on something really, really dark. So if it's got a little transparency to it, I don't think that's going to matter too awfully much. I know. I just go for it. Poor Jean. It's a good thing she isn't getting her knickers in a twist over there. Yes. Like that really a lot. Because it does have transparency to it, but yet it still stands out.
Yeah, that looks good. Yeah. The dark brown. Yeah.
Yeah, the dark brown. It really worked out well. And I can get a reverse off of it too. Yep. Yeah. All good.
Yeah, now Jean's laughing.
I know it. It is amazing, though, how much pressure you guys have to put on these little things, even the baby here, to get it to pull up like that. Oh, that's a nice one, too. Look at that one. Isn't that cool?
Oh, I like that one.
You want me to learn kamikaze painting, printing? Kamikaze printing. My handwriting pretty much looks like kamikaze printing to begin with. So, Joycey is sumi wrestling. That would not surprise me in the least. Oh, okay. So, let's. I think we all had a firm handle on that one. Oh, my stars. We love you, Joycey.
She wants to have Joycey, let's all hang out when you're jelly plating.
You know, I think jelly plating, oh, this feels a little thick. I think jelly plating has, and I've seen some fabulous, fabulous prints come out of it, but it has its little quirks. And with that, what did I just do with that? Oh, here it is, right in front of my face. With that just comes experimental play. There's no two ways to get about that.
That's the fun part. It just varies so much. And you just keep playing and experimenting and keep working on it until you get something you like.
Yeah, for sure. I am finding this. Now, I thought it would be fun, but I'm finding it extremely fun, and I didn't think it would be, at least not for me. I thought it would look like it's too much work, and it's not. Other than image transfer, shall we say, that's a lot of work, but it is so worth it.
No, it is fun.
Okay. That. What I like for this is it's going to give me a lot of small pieces that I can rip up and put into art journaling. I think that's kind of cool.
Yeah.
All right, so this has to dry. You know, Debbie, I was thinking that same thing and then feeling incredibly greedy because I was thinking that same thing. But I'm going to have to do it. On my summer budget, I'm going to have to break down and get the rest of these little shapes because they are just delightful. So delightful. Okay, do I want to do that? No, I think I'll just go over this one. I want to try this on tissue paper too.
Yeah, if you use tissue paper, you have to be a little quicker because it can tear so thin.
Yes. Bye, Sharon, honey. Thank you. Hey, do me a favor, Sharon, and DM me your telephone number, please. Have a great weekend, and I hope Brian enjoys his fishing and is feeling well enough for that. Oh, I'm not sure if you can see the subtle little marking in this. Look at that. Is that cool or what? Fabulous texture. Yeah, lickable, right, Joycey? Absolutely lickable. Yeah. Love that. Oh, okay. I love these little multi print stencils. They're just really fun because you get parts of something and parts of another. And I think that's really cool. This one is, called, oh, this is a Designs My, this is one of the Art by Marlene, Designs by Marlene. Let me see if I can get this within. There we go. There you have it. I like this stencil. And the other ones were from iStencil.com, and I think they were either Joan's or within Patty's Tolly Parishes. I'm not sure. But let's try. No, I already did this color, didn't I? I did. Or didn't I? Oh, I don't know. No, I want some blue ones. I don't. Whoops. There was my computer again. Every time I mess with this box, my computer goes flying. And let's get bright yellow. That'll work. Which yellow? These two. So. I'll do the blue. Yes, the three limbs and casts. Sounds like my son, Sharon. Be sure to tweet, DM me your phone number, sweetie. Okay. Okay, wait, let's. You know, if I do a big sheet, I don't have to tear them up. I can just keep turning it over, right? Right. Yeah, I looked really hard and had the postcard sized one. What is it? 3x5 or something like that. I don't know. It's an odd sized, but I looked at that one a lot because I wanted another option for card making, and I thought that would be fun, but I could see doing this on cards, letting it dry, and then, you know, you're ready to go with a little bit of a sentiment. And I don't think I had enough paint on there this time, though. Look at that. I've got a lot left on here, but it didn't really transfer off.
Yeah. You could turn the stencil over and try to get the on the stencil on
my paper. Yeah.
Try that. Sometimes if it's still wet enough, you can do that.
Yeah, I'm not sure if it's gonna. Yeah, it's. I think it might have been not. Yeah, I don't think it was dry enough. Oh, this glove has said we're done. New glove time. Woo! Sweaty hands.
Just like washing your hands. New gloves.
Yeah. And Kathy Berg was very kind to send me some of her fabulous soap. And you guys have no idea how many thank you cards I still have to make for my tag book. I've got like two cards done because of life. I was down all weekend, stuck in bed again. I made a joke that I think I've got an alien inside waiting to pop out, like from Aliens. Wow. It's hard to do this when you've got like sweaty hands.
Yep. Baby powder. You need baby powder to get it.
Yeah, I guess. We have got tons of these things because of when David was in hospice. We have gloves everywhere. Okay. Lena, what time is it there right now? Okay, that's good enough. And that should probably be dry. Oh, 6:30. That's not bad. And Dot, is it 6:30 by you or 5:30 by you? Yes, okay. I thought you were probably another hour closer to us. Well, now I can go back over that one with more green, right?
Yeah, Bon, you can do it whatever you want. Just play around with any kind of colors that you like. You can try green, something darker with look good with the yellow.
Yeah. Well, let me try the black because that greenish tint that's on there, although it's got to dry first, the greenish tint thing that's on there right now is a combination of those lighter colors. And before I forget, please remember to thumbs up so that other newcomers can help find a beginners for beginners jelly plating. And thank you all for coming. I really appreciated it. Oh, that turned out really great, even with that little bit of white spot there. Can you guys see the colors? Oh my goodness, my lighting is just awful. There we go. Can see it a little bit better there.
Yes. There it is. You can see it now. Very good.
Yeah. especially with those little yellow, strong yellow dots left over from the previous pull. This is really cool. Come on, focus. There we go. Yeah, those non-perfect background. This is really amazing to me. This one, in real life, wait till I show you guys the photo print of it. It looks like a peacock feather. It's got all of that peacock feather goodness to it. Amazing. Amazing. Of course, I'll never remember which pigments I used out of this acrylic batch. You know, I'm wondering if that's part of the difference here today as well, is that I'm using a lower quality acrylic paint versus like the folk art paint that you guys tend to use, right?
Well, I think the paints you're using are a little bit better quality than the regular craft paint is.
You think so? These are Master's Touch, which is Hobby Lobby's house brand. I thought Dale Rowney made Hobby Lobby's house brand.
I'm not sure.
Because I think Dale Rowney is, I don't know where Dale Rowney is, to be honest with you. I thought they were based out of China.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I know.
Oh, no, they're in Berkshire. Oh, they're made in England. So, yeah. Who am I thinking of that makes the Chinese brand? I can't think.
I don't know. I like what Jean said, because I use Artist Loft and Liquitex Student Grade also in the tube.
Do you?
That's for me too, Jean. I agree.
Okay. Well, I don't know. I just figured it would have to work for me today. Let's try a silver. And what can we go with this silver?
Aw, thank you, Judy. So sweet.
She is cute. You should go to her Etsy store and to her their business page, which I link. By the way, I linked those on my blog for today, so you can go there. She's adorable, as cute as a button. Ooh, this one is really transparent. I'm not sure how that's going to work.
Aw, thank you. That was so nice of you. Great group of kids.
Okay. All right, let's find, yes. Oh, let's.
Von Ian just said that the lower quality paint is best or better for a jelly plate, as it is more transparent.
Oh, well, there you have it. Thank you, Ian. Bye, Kimberly. Love you, sweetie.
Thanks. Bye.
If I don't talk to you again, have a great weekend. Yes, I know, the life of a farmer. My son has a little farm out in the burgs of Parker, Colorado, with a little. And I'll tell you what, he stays so busy with that. Plus working full-time for a while. He was working a full-time job and a part-time job. And trying to maintain the farm. Luckily, his wife is very active with the farm as well. She makes handmade goat soap. Soap out of goat. It's beautifully fragranced. Handmade soap. It's wonderful out of goat's milk. Oh! That turned out awesome right there. Okay, so now let's try a little silver on this and see what happens. Oh, I got to wait for that to dry, don't I?
Yeah, let it dry. I think silver would.
I hope so. It might not be dark enough, though. I am so glad I did not allow the grandkitty in here today. Oh my stars, I think I'd have a complete fiasco. He likes to try and get on my armrest and help me paint.
Yep. You have little pinky paws.
Yes. He's the biggest goofus. Last night that was thundering here so bad that I'm Django Puppy. He gets scared with the thunder, so the kids had him come in, and he actually jumped into bed. Usually he lays down next to my daughter because she and I are both his safety blankets, and he actually jumped into bed with them and settled down, and then the two kitties were so incensed that he got to be in there and they couldn't, that they were jumping up and body slamming the door so they could be let in. And my son, I had to get up and kick everybody out. I felt so bad for the puppy. Yes, it would probably be very entertaining for you, AJ, if you could see the fiasco I go through every time I sit down at this desk to play. Oh, if I have that door open, he is just the biggest goofus. And of course, if I don't let him near me, then he curls up in my bed as if, well, this bed belongs to me, my brand new bed, my adjustable bed, right? And then I have to feel guilty to kick him off of it so I can get into it. And then he's got they both have the teeny tiniest baby cries you've ever heard. And like Simba, his bigger brother must be 12 to 15 pounds, he's this beast. And Kick is more active, so he's littler, but they both have these little baby kitty cries.
Fur babies.
Yeah. Can you see that? Is that cool or what? Now, I would like to do this one again to pick up what I didn't press down here hard enough. That is so pretty. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Yes, I like that. I'd like to try that one again. Maybe reverse it this time, though. Silver first and then the blue. But it's quite ridiculous how those two sound like little babies when they're big honking beasts, you know? I can't have Simba sitting on my lap. He's too heavy. The neuro in my legs can't handle it. And then he wants to be on your chest, and then he headbutts your chin, and you can just hear it cracking because his headbutt's so strong. He's a pistol. Yeah, there are babies. Our babies. The kids initially got them both for Django to have somebody to play with because Poppy's and my kitty was older, and their kitty Jazzy was older, and she was a fussy butt, and ours was a fussy butt, like don't touch me type. And so we thought getting kitties for Django to have playmates would be fun. But the kitties came with claws and didn't have the good sense not to claw the dickens out of his tail and his nose. And so he got scared. So now every time they come near his tail or his nose, he growls at them. Ugh. Every once in a while, he and Kick will get the zoomies and go running around the house because it's got a circular walk pattern from their living room into my sitting room, into the kitchen, and into the formal dining room. And it makes that loop. I am obviously not pushing hard enough here. It's not coming off very well.
Like that.
Gee, that's really cool. I'm only going to go till noon and then we'll do a close up and take one final look at some of the prints today and let everybody go and get on with their weekend.
Right, Debbie, I agree. Debbie just said that the smaller openings in the stencil, the harder it is to get the paint to go through it.
Oh.
So if you use stencils with larger openings, it would work better.
Oh, well, that's good to know.
Yeah, I agree. That makes sense, Debbie. Gee.
So something like this might work better, Debbie?
Yeah,
okay. Well, I have like this one too. And I have some small stencils that have larger designs and patterns on them, too. So, yeah.
I like that one, the flower kind
yeah.
of one.
Yeah. Well, I love all of them. I think these are so cool. I love the starburst look to it, you know?
Yeah, that one, the starburst look one. Yeah. That
looks
good.
Oh, that turned out nice.
Yeah, Colleen says, yes, larger.
Yeah. That's right. Colleen is streaming tonight at 6 o'clock. That is the Scrap Chick, THESCRAPCHIC. I don't know if it's chick or chic, but I like that. Yeah, I like that pull. That turned out really good. Well, let's try one of these larger ones or larger shaped ones and see what happens with it. Oh, this would work really cool with it right there. Let's do a teal and
I agree, Debbie. Debbie said, I'm loving what your prints are looking like. They're so pretty.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, I agree. You're doing so good for your very first time using a Gelli Plate.
Well, see, that's where I think having somebody to help guide you makes a big difference. I like, let's see. I like this color and yeah. Which one is this? This is ocean green. And yeah, I'm going to take these two colors. I like that.
Oh. Yes, and that you passed the trial by fire.
I did, didn't I? Well, having all of you guys and having Norma here has helped directly, because Norma's ability to help me troubleshoot verbally is really helpful too.
I don't know if I've been that much help. I'm trying to, my computer, I have to keep hitting the live button to keep up, and then chat, there's a lag, and then I have to remember not to talk when you have the dryer on. There's a lot to remember, Bob.
Well, you know what? I do the same thing, so don't take it personal. That's, you know, it's just half the fun. Well, just learning to, juggle is what I'm learning to do, is how to juggle everything. Oh, my stars.
Yeah. Oh, juggling. That's a good term.
Yeah. Well, and I'm working on a corner desk unit, and I have to make a trip to IKEA, but I'm not going to do that until Mick's arm is restored and fully functional and he's good to go again for full use, because he tore the tendon just below his elbow badly. And so he can't lift anything heavy at all with that arm, or he risks breaking the other tendon. Apparently there's two of them. So, you know, and he's my go-to guy for getting those big boxes from IKEA and hauling them into the house and putting all that stuff together. And I said to them the other day that I think anything else that I have can wait until next year when everybody is feeling better again in this house. Because I can make do with this corner desk unit. I've been using it for years. It'll continue to work for me just fine.
That's good. What a great attitude.
Oh, you know what? I am blessed to be here. I am blessed to have the materials I have and the friends I have. And I'm blessed to wake up every morning with a goal in mind to create art or talk to friends, or, you know, I'm finally loosening up on, you know, remember when telephones used to be awful expensive to call across country? I'm finally getting it through my head that it doesn't cost me anything. And I've had my cell phone for, 15 years now? It's crazy. It's crazy. I do have two awesome daughters, baby girl one and baby girl two. I have two awesome sons and two fabulous daughter-in-laws and one fabulous son-in-law. He is the most giving, loving, godly man I've ever known. I'm so blessed. I always say if I had searched the whole world over, I would never have found someone as good as he to marry my daughter. And she found him all by herself.
Aw, that's great.
Yeah, he is great. My daughter-in-law's too. I am really, really blessed. Okay, now. Well, wait, I have to just press this one down without the stencil, right? That's what I'm doing. I'm getting the relief. Oh, heavens. Well, and you know, with the foam thing, I always worry, because here I sit, you know, for the most part every day, unless I'm at a stream, I have all this time in the world. And I just think, oh, I should pick up the phone and call so-and-so. And then I think, well, what if I'm interrupting them? Or what if they're busy? Or what if they can't take the call, and or they don't want to take the call right then? And then they feel bad or guilty, and I don't want to do that to them. And then I just finally thought, you know what? I'm going to make the call, tell them I love them, I'm thinking of them, call me back when they have a moment, and just let it go. Rather than putting the burden on me to not tell them, I'd rather put the burden on them to be the ones to just let me know when it's appropriate. I loved how the other night when I called you, Norma, and you just said you were on a phone call at the moment, and could you call me back? And I said, how about tomorrow? And we just left it at that. I love that. Works out so nicely.
I've learned to do that and not feel guilty. If I can't take a call, I'd rather tell somebody that. Apologize and say, we can do it later. And then also, too, what I do is when I call people, I'll sometimes say, hey, do you got a minute or do you have time now to talk?
Yes.
And if they say no, I'm fine with that.
Yep.
I'll call late. Yeah.
And that's all you have to do. It does. It works great. That's all you have to do. And I'm learning that with my kids too, but also just texting, I love you. Usually I do it later in the day where it's not first thing in the morning. They're trying to get, off to work. But at some point in the day, I'll text and just say, I love you. Especially my boys, because, I tend to talk to my daughter-in-laws more quickly than I do my boys, because they're the, usually the ones that are so busy. And okay, so I've got some beautiful color left on here. I need to find something to do with that. That's because that's really pretty. I think I'll take this rose color. Which one is this? Permanent red, crimson. I'll take crimson. Ugh, yellow. You know, these wipe off papers that I have over here, off to the side, some of them are really ugly. That's where you get the white gesso out, right?
Yeah, you get the white gesso out or the white paint and cover over the ugly.
Yay, because they're just kind of ugly. Ugly. Yeah, that's true, Joycey. Is this a good time? I usually do that, like with my sister, too, because she's always, I'll tell you what, that is one busy lady. I don't know how she gets half as much done as she does. And she has health issues, too. She is a mover. Ooh. Oh, I like that. Okay. So I have the red. Now what do I want to do with that? Yeah, I bet you the black would work good to pull some of that color off on this one. I gotta find my
black. It's pretty.
This one right here. Yeah, and I'm thinking I'm gonna find my black to pull off this, because that red and that blue that's on there would really, I think. Except I can't find my blacks. So that's
Black might not work. Use something lighter. Maybe something lighter on that, like a silver or a yellow or a gold.
Well, I do have gold. Yeah, the gold might work really well for that.
Oh, Shauna is leaving.
Bye, Shauna.
Bye.
Love you, girl. Talk to you later. Maybe not. The gold may have dried up and been the only one to dry up in its tube. It is.
Oh.
Oh. Yep, it is. It's all dried up. It's got this little hard nugget in there. Some of it feels moist, but some of it doesn't. So, yeah, no, throwing it away. Okay, so let me try the silver then. See, all the yellows I've got are like, well, actually, though, this would work really well. This is that yellow ochre. It's a pretty color. It would work well with that. Okay. Is anybody is it bothering anybody? I'm not hearing it, but then I've got other, you know, I've got the fans going in here, so
I'm gonna go close the door anyway. Be right back.
Okay. I don't think it was dry enough.
Okay, I'm back.
Okay. Yeah, I don't think it was dry enough, to be honest with you. Some of what was underneath, I don't think it was dry enough.
Yeah, possibly. Yeah. It's always kind of a crapshoot. Never really know. That's kind of the fun of playing with it. It just varies so much.
Bye, Judy. You take care. Stay safe, honey. Know you're in prayers and heart. Check in at Twitter, please. Yes, you'll see us at Colleen's tonight, too. But if weather gets really bad, please check in at Twitter. Thank you, honey. And this is going to be my last poll, I think, because I would like to... do a recap. Oh, I like that. Yes, I like that. I'm going to get that off of there and then call it good. It's dry. Yeah. I love red and yellow ochre together. Those colors are so pretty. I think it's one of the reasons why I was so intrigued with the water lily, which is still not finished, because of that red water lily and then all of the yellow around it.
Okay. I love this baby jelly. It's so, so cute. Thank you, Joan. I didn't even haul out the bookmark stencils that I got from you. I'll have to play with those another time and show you what I do with them. Your stencils are awesome.
I agree, Joan. I played with your stencils last night. I was doing some practice with my jelly plate, and I love your stencils. Awesome.
Oh, yeah. That didn't turn out too bad. I like both of them, actually. I like how the blue pulled off with that one. I love this red, or this blue and red one here, and then the red and blue. I love how that's kind of there and not there on the texture. It's really cool. Love the spots of blue coming through, almost as if it's rusted, rust patina on it. Yeah, I am really, really impressed with jelly plating. I never understood it, of course, because I don't think one can really understand it until they do it. But when you sit down and start playing with it, it's just like magic. And
I'm so glad you had fun doing it. You just play around and it's fun.
Yeah.
But keep improving on the results that you get. You always think, okay, the next one's going to be better. That's the fun of it.
Yes, I agree. And we've got this with some metallic in it. I may have to get some more metallic paints because those are so pretty. I love them.
I agree.
Yeah.
I think the silver and blue together, that's a great combination.
Oh, it is. Well, it's very Christmassy. You know, you would see that like on a Christmas bulb type thing. This one, though, looks like a peacock.
Yeah.
This paint has got a lot of shine to it built in. And that's kind of amazing to me that it almost looks shellacked in some areas. This one gets me all excited here too. It's much darker on screen than what it is in real life. So I promise I'm going to take photos of all of these. It'll probably be tomorrow because I think my body's kind of done at the desk today and I still have some cleanup to do here. So I love these. I love this leopard print, and I love how the white shines through here with a little bit of the dark brown grunge. Really cool. But this one, oh my stars, love, love, love this one. And it looks a lot redder on screen than what it is in reality. It's much more of the rust orange red with the leaves still being that sap green color and going into yellow. And oh, and then you got some deep, the only thing it's missing, no, actually it's got a little bit of burgundy down over in here too. This one's probably my favorite. I like this one, though, too, because of all of the color combinations in it. It's got pink and teal and black and white. I love that. And this one, my first image transfer. How fun. Actually, this one's probably my favorite. And you can't even see it. You're not going to see this until I take a photo of it. How gorgeous this one is. Amazing. I like these too, though. I really love these two. And this one that looks so Christmassy. Look at that. How fun is that?
And these were the other pulls for it right here. I liked this one. And this one was, I think part of this one. I'm not sure. I can't remember how I got this one. It just kind of, bam, and it was there. So it is great to learn something new. And I think the more that you experiment and play, you're never bored because you've always got something new to play with. And I tend to cycle through stuff. You know, I'll do watercolor. I'll do oil. I'll do some oil pastel. I'll do soft pastel. I'll do colored pencil, which, trust me, by the time you get done with a colored pencil piece, you are very happy to work into something else. They are extremely time consuming. They're beautiful. It's a beautiful, beautiful medium, but it is very time consuming. I also love this one. It's got sap green and yellow green and purple and a little bit of hint of pink and white and dark green and a little bit of grunge brown in it. And it's just magical. Love that one. I like this little print here too. And this one, of course, I love. I love this cast off relief. So cool. And this was some of my attempts at start on copy paper, which I will know not to use again unless I can figure out what I'm doing wrong there. So I did this one onto cardstock. I did this onto grocery sack. And I never did get some of my other stuff used today, but I will. I will. So thank you, everybody. No, Gillian was, yes, she was lurking, but she was here early on. She said hi right off the bat. Jillian, I always call her Gillian. I am so sorry, Jillian. I am just horrible, horrible, horrible with not remembering how to pronounce your name.
And, yeah, funny, I always call her Kia.
Yeah. Kia, I know, I should. I should. But thank you, thanks, everyone.
Everybody. Yeah. All the kind comments. It was so nice. Bon, you did great. Look at all that you've done today. Amazing.
Norma, thank you. Thank you so much for the box of goodies. That's like a gift that keeps on giving and will keep on giving in many, many ways. And and I just appreciate everything that you've done and your willingness to do this with me because, you know, when you're sitting here alone and you've got chatters, which are lovely, but having somebody live voice with you, it's like a security blanket, and I appreciate you being there for me today.
Well, thank you for inviting me. I feel so honored. It was fun. It was really great. I don't know how much help I really was, but you're so terrific. Everyone, just such encouragement. It's great.
Yeah. I love this gig. Love them, love them. All right, guys, we're going to shut it down. Remember, you can call me, text me if you have it, and if you need it, Twitter DM me. You can send a message through my Facebook page and Messenger. All of that is linked off my blog, theyvonne.com. And, yep, Colleen is streaming tonight at 6:30 Eastern Standard. That's The Scrap Chick, TheScrapChic. And we're good to go. I love you all. Thank you so much for being here. And I will see you next time. And I have no idea what we're going to be doing next time, but there will be a next time, I hope. Bye-bye. We're counting down. 3, 2, 1. Goodbye, gang. Happy weekend.